In this video, I will be demonstrating the landmarks that are used in case of a cleft lip surgery. Now, for cleft lip, there are different techniques, but it is important to know that there are certain landmarks which are basic for all these techniques. So, in this, I will not be showing the flaps and the techniques, but only the landmarks that are used. Now, before drawing it, because you will be asked to do so in the exam, especially in your practical vivas, you should know the orientation with which the nose and the lip are drawn. Now, sometimes in a hurry, we may end up drawing the nose and then the lip somewhere here or the lip somewhere here, but these are wrong. What you need to know is that the nose is drawn in such a way that this is the normal side, since the most common cleft lip is on the left side, that is where I'll be demonstrating it. So the nose and the alar base on the cleft side are broader and the columella is shorter. Now, before drawing the lip, you should keep the center of the columella as a guideline, because the peak of the cupid's bow actually falls within that line in cases of the cleft lip as well. Now, the peak of the cupid's bow that you will be drawing is actually lower on the normal side and it is higher on the cleft side. I am demonstrating an incomplete cleft lip. And when you draw the vermilion on the cleft side, it actually starts to thin at a certain level. And then the lower lip can be easily completed. Now, the cleft side is also known as the lateral side, hence L. And the non-cleft side is also known as the medial side, hence M. Now, the first point, that is point 1, is the peak of the cupid's bow. Point 2 is the peak of the cupid's bow on the non-cleft side. The distance between 1 and 2 is measured with the help of a caliper in order to get to point 3, which will be the peak of the cupid's bow on the cleft side. Now, this point 4, there is a debate on how to actually get this point. This point is also known as Nordhoff's point. In certain instances, the distance between the angle of the mouth and peak of cupid's bow on the non-cleft side can be calculated, and similarly this distance can be taken to mark the point 4 on the cleft side. But because the lip is a sphincter, the lip is constricted on the cleft side, so this may not give us the proper guideline. So point 4 is actually marked where the vermilion starts to thin or there is maximum thickness of the white roll. Now, all these landmarks are actually made onto the white roll and not in the vermilion, and they are tattooed before surgery. Then comes point 5, which is the center of the base of the columella. Now, point 6 is the base of the columella on the non-cleft side, and akin to that is point 7, which is the base of the columella on the cleft side. Now, point 8 is the base of the ala on the non-cleft side, and equidistance, such as 6 and 8. From 7, we'll get a point 9, which is where the base of the ala will lie on the cleft side. So these landmarks are all important and they are the base for doing any flap. Now, similarly, you should practice to make the lip for the opposite side, because in certain cases you will be asked to draw the right side. So for those cases, practice is definitely required, otherwise you may not get the proper orientation. So in this case, the lip would lie over here, higher on this side. And similarly, you would mark your points 1, this would be 2, 3, get point 4, and the remaining in the similar manner.